Welcome to Mawson Dock. Make yourself comfortable while we finish some preliminary ship checks. My name's Theo Acosta, and I'll be running your Pilots Federation evaluation. Most pilots assigned to me earn their license, so as long as you follow my instructions, you'll be a commander in no time. Oh, and before you ask, I may sound like an Imperial, but I'm actually from an independent system. Today we'll be covering the basics of flight control, combat, and frameshift drive use. This sidewinder has been installed with a specialized computer that'll take control at certain points. Mostly you'll follow a series of objectives to guide your actions. These are shown in the info panel at the top right of the head-up display. Okay, you're good to go. Select auto-launch from the options ahead of you when you're ready.
Ship release confirmed. Auto-launch sequence underway.
The beauty of auto-launch is that you can relax and enjoy the view. One of the ways that technology allows us to appreciate the good things in life. Other applicants are departing for their own evaluations, but this isn't a race. Each of the coming stages can be completed at your own pace. Resume a stationary position. Your throttle can also be pulled back from zero to engage reverse thrust. A series of checkpoints. Head towards the course, following the target indicator. The course weaves through an orbital structure and is designed for the novice pilot. Accelerate through the first checkpoint when you're ready to start. Fly through the center of the first checkpoint. You'll notice that they change color as you fly through them. We should probably begin soon. Never mind. You've got it. And we're off. There's no time limit, so maintain a comfortable speed while you familiarize yourself with the controls. Pitching together is the most efficient way of turning rapidly. Practice to consider the angle and speed of your approach. See the blue marker beside the throttle gauge. This indicates the optimum turning speed. Thank you. approaching a particularly sharp turn, so I advise slowing down to prevent any mishaps. Your ship's boost function greatly increases your speed, but use it wisely. That's the last checkpoint. The Sidewinder is an agile craft, and you handled it well. A new icon has appeared on the sensor display in the center of your dashboard. This represents a nearby beacon, which you'll soon scan as part of your evaluation. Target the beacon before we continue. You're going to use your ship's data link scanner to analyze the beacon, but you need to deploy hardpoints first. Good. Most external modules are installed on hardpoints, including weapons. Control is back with you. The beacon is relatively small, so you'll need to position yourself close to it. While your patience is admirable, you can open the throttle a little more here. Tool that connects with network interfaces and various data points. You need to move to another area of this star system to continue your assessment, pilot. Rather than travel for the next year using your thrusters, you can employ the ship's frameshift drive to increase your speed by a few orders of magnitude. First, ensure that the ship is correctly secured. Your landing gear, cargo scoop, and hardpoints must all be retracted. When you're ready, throttle up and engage supercruise.
Frameshift drive charging. Ready to engage. 4, 3, 2, 1, engage.
All readouts look good. You're now accelerating towards a velocity comparative to the speed of light, measured in C. Supercruise is used to navigate within a star system, allowing you to cover significant distances in minutes. Usually you'll retain control in supercruise, but on this occasion your ship's computer is following a preset path. This is a good time to familiarize yourself with a couple of the cockpit panels available to you. In the top left of your HUD is the comms panel, which displays pilot communications and contacts across several channels. The top right is your info panel. Entries here mostly relate to your ship's status, computer messages, and events happening around you. Ah, there we go. Welcome to Lightspeed. Watch the distance and speed markers on the dashboard. These are used to help you accurately disengage at your destination. Your next lesson will introduce the basics of combat. Several static and mobile targets will be provided around a decommissioned megaship. We'll also cover some situational information about weaponry and target tracking. And yes, you'll get to shoot those weapons you saw earlier. Effect on the FSD, reducing your ship's speed. The closer the body, the greater the effect. The frameshift drive is disengaged. Welcome to the combat zone. Before you start shooting, however, try analyzing the megaship with a data link scanner. It's often worth scanning objects you're unfamiliar with to learn more about them. Next, you need to activate your weapons by cycling to a different fire group. You'll notice that your weapons are now listed on your HUD. Fire groups allow you to manage your hardpoints efficiently. Let's begin the combat evaluation. Destroy several of the canisters. All weapons have an effective range, so you may need to move closer here. Thrusters are particularly useful for navigating around large structures. Why not give them a try? Your cannon will automatically reload until the ammunition supply runs out. Meanwhile, your laser will fire until the capacitor is depleted, at which point it will need to recharge. Try targeting the canister you're aiming at. Quota achieved. Let's dial up the challenge a notch, shall we? An unmanned craft has arrived nearby. These drones are used by the Pilots Federation as target practice, and they're quite harmless. To continue, bring the craft into your sights and open fire. I recommend targeting your opponent during combat. Notice how your reticules move towards your target. Your ship's gimbaled weapons offer a degree of aiming assistance.
Target destroyed.
Nice work. You may have noticed that multi-cannons are effective against unshielded targets. Another craft has arrived. This one is fitted with a shield generator. Helpfully, your burst laser is a thermal weapon, which excels at stripping away a target's shields. Consider me impressed. Your final target has dropped into the area. This time your opponent will fight back, but its damage capability has been greatly reduced. Your target will not react until it registers shield damage. Engage when ready. last target. Even if you're planning on a peaceful career, understanding the basics of combat is vital for a pilot's long-term survival. For advanced combat information, you should refer to the pilot's handbook, which we'll cover in more detail soon. The next step of your evaluation involves a hyperspace jump to a neighboring star system. On this occasion, your ship's computer has selected your destination for you. We'll cover selecting destinations manually soon. The mass lock indicator on the bottom right of the dashboard is active. This means a large object is in close proximity, preventing you from engaging the FSD. To resolve this, throttle up to move a safe distance away from the megaship. Remember, you can boost to temporarily increase your ship's speed. The mass lock indicator has gone out. When you are ready to travel light years in seconds, engage the FSD.
Frameshift drive charging. Selected, throttle up and aim towards your target. The compass to the left of the sensor display will help you orient yourself. Good. Your ship is now bound for Quello Station. Let's take a moment to review the interface panels either side of your chair. The external panel is primarily used to interact with the galaxy around you. For example, you can access maps, display contracts, and review nearby objects. Meanwhile, the internal panel displays information about you and your ship. You can adjust module functions, check your records, and access the codex, among other things. Often wonder what their first step into the galaxy should be. The pilot's handbook is a great source of help in this regard. It details a variety of professions and how to outfit your ship for them. The handbook also offers advice on various ship functions that aren't covered in this evaluation. You can find the pilot's handbook in the codex, accessible on the home screen via the internal interface panel. The trails moving around you are FSD wakes. Your ship is also emitting one. The position of each correlates with their respective sensor display icons. In a moment, we'll be going through the docking process. This will cover docking permissions and a standard landing pad approach. stretch. You'll dock here shortly, but I'd like you to position your ship near the starport's access corridor first. Starports are the backbone of humanity's operations throughout inhabited space. They provide mission boards, the commodities market, a number of specialized contacts, and various ship facilities. Most pilot business is conducted via the Starport Services interface. I recommend familiarizing yourself with this screen when docked. Good. Ease off the throttle and hold position here. Oh, and try not to block the access corridor. We'll be using the docking computer for this landing. You can always dock manually in future, of course, but practice in a training simulation first. Whichever method you use, all ships must seek docking permission before approaching a landing pad. To request docking permission, open your external interface panel and select the Contacts tab. Then select Quello Station in the list, followed by Request Docking in the Information panel.
Docking permission authorized. Docking assist has been engaged.
You've been assigned Landing Pad 3. The compass will point towards your designated pad. Ships need to be within 7.5 kilometers of a starport for a docking request to be considered. The docking computer will now demonstrate a safe landing procedure. Let's review what it's doing. Landing gear must be deployed. The related dashboard indicator lights up if this has been done.
Landing gear deployed.
Thank you, and enjoy your stay.
In a moment, the sensor display will switch to the precision approach display, which helps you accurately set belly down on the landing pad. Congratulations, Commander. Your evaluation has been successful, and a license is being assigned to you as I speak. We just need to finalize your credentials. Enter the hangar to exit this evaluation. It's time to blaze your own trail across the galaxy. The manner in which you do so is up to you.
Your new ship, Commander. Your pilot's Federation license has been issued, and you're free to traverse the galaxy as an independent pilot. Before launching for the first time, allow me to quickly introduce the basic interface for mission contracts. Almost all pilots will use the mission board at some stage. A contract has been assigned to you. Active missions are displayed in the Transactions tab of the external interface panel. This time you'll need to travel to Mawson Dock in the Dromi system. You can select these destinations at the navigation screen of the external interface panel. If you'd like to practice your journey first, I recommend the training simulations accessed via the internal interface panel. To review what we've discussed, select your comms panel and scroll through the recorded text. I'll contact you at Mawson Dock if you decide to complete this mission. If you choose to take a different path, then I wish you luck, Commander.